Good morning all of you. My name is B. Harish. Welcome to 4th year, 1st semester. In this semester, you are going to learn about an important as well as interesting subject, that is optical communication. The prescribed textbooks for studying this course are Optical Fiber Communication by Gerd Kaiser and Optical Fiber Communication by John M. Senior. The contents present in the Unit 1 are Overview and History of Optical Fiber, the General Block Diagram or General System of Optical Fiber, and the Advantages of Optical Fiber over Conventional Coaxial Cable System. The next one is Optical Fiber Waveguides, Ray Transmission Theory, Cylindrical Fibers, Step Index Fibers, Grade Index Fibers, and some very interesting miscellaneous topics. First of all, what is meant by communication system? As you already learned in the previous semesters, some communication subjects. So what are they? Analog communication, digital communication. Okay. So first of all, what is meant by communication? Communication means the transfer of information from one end to another end. Okay. Transfer of information from one point to another point is called as communication. This communication is done in so many techniques. Okay, but the interesting way of communicating the information signal, which is in the form of light, that you are going to study in this course. You can see optical communication. What is my optic? Optic means light. Means you are going to transmit your information in the form of light from one point to another point. So very interesting. But you have studied semesters about communication system, that is transmitting the signals, information signals from one point to another point in the form of electrical signals. Okay, so we are not using electrical signals here. We are using light. So we are transmitting the information signal in the form of light from one point to another point. So this kind of communication is called as optical communication. Okay, so here the light forms as an electromagnetic carrier wave, which is modulated to carry the information signal. Okay, so what are the, first of all, why we are going to optical communication? Because there are certain disadvantages in the conventional coaxial cable system. Okay, conventional coaxial cable system. You can see the diagram. Already we know this. Everybody we are using in our daily life. Every day we are looking at that coaxial cable. Okay, so it is a nothing but a copper wire which is insulated with some rubber or plastic. Okay, so there are some disadvantages in conventional coaxial cable system. So what are the disadvantages? Since it is carrying carrying the metal copper wire, so if you observe, the weight of the coaxial cable is very high. Okay, so that is the first one. Next one is bandwidth is low. It offers very less bandwidth. If you want to transmit more information in less time, conventional coaxial cable system is not suitable. Okay, the next one is signals are transmitted in the electrical form. Okay, when the signals are transmitted in the electrical form, obviously there is a huge chance of power loss. There is a lot of chance of power loss. Okay, the next one is more prone to crosstalk. Anybody can steal cable here anywhere and can steal the data and can steal the information. Yes or no? So there is a prone. A common man can do that. They can cut the cable, they can steal the data. So there is no information security. There is no information security in conventional coaxial cable system. Okay. So these are all the disadvantages present in the conventional coaxial cable system, which can be overcome in optical communication system. Okay. So who invented the optical communication system first of all? Okay. First, who invented this? So everybody know a famous scientist, that is Alexander Graham Bell. Okay, Alexander Graham Bell. He introduced a device called as photophone. called as this photophone is also called as radiophone. This photophone is also called as radiophone. When in the year 1880, when in the year 1880, Alexander Graham Bell introduced a device called as photophone, where in the Bell Volta lab, this Bell labs is still present and lot of research work is going on. It is in US. Okay. So what he have done? So he introduced a device, okay, which is called as radiophone or photophone, which is able to transmit the voice signals from one point to another point in the form of light. In the form of light. Okay. You can see here. This is the pic of Alexander Graham Bell. He is sitting in front of the setup. What he has done? He has taken the receiver here. He has taken the mic. Okay. He is talking something. Okay. That is, he is transmitting the voice signals in the form of, and they are transmitting in the form of light. This is the setup of radiophone or photophone in the Bell Volta labs by the Alexander Graham Bell. Later in the latter years, it was developed as a complete optical communication system. In the year, say for example, 1975, it was completely transformed into, the device is completely transformed into optical communication system with very interesting optical sources at the transmitter end. Like, what are optical sources? So transmitting the information in the form of LED light, transmitting the information in the form of laser light, okay, for which they are using some gallium semiconductor lasers, etc. So still we are able to utilize the services of optical communication system in our daily life, at our homes. The best example is fiber net. The best example is fiber net. We are all using fiber net, internet. We are accessing the internet at our home with the help of fiber optic, optical fiber cables. Okay. So what are the advantages of, what are the applications of this optical fiber cable? Where it is used actually? Only for the internet? No. You can see there are so many applications, especially in medical applications. Okay. Especially in medical applications like endoscopic imaging. Okay. What is endoscopic imaging? Endoscopy means if any person is suffering from some gas disorders, the gastroenterologist will insert a long pipe with a camera at the end into the stomach through the mouth. So what is that pipe actually? It is an optical fiber. It is an optical fiber. It captures the video, it captures the images and transmits to the computer within no time. Okay. So in the medical field, these optical fibers are used. Nowadays, still we are using them. Okay. And long distance communications, as I said, LAN, cable TV, okay, as I said, fiber net is the best example for long distance communication. And another one is in military applications. As I said, in conventional coaxial cable system, you can cut the coaxial cable anywhere. You can cut the coaxial cable anywhere. You can steal the data. So that kind of coaxial cable are not used, cannot be used in military applications. Okay. But in fiber optic communication, if you detach the fiber optic cable, it is not possible for any common man, it is not possible for any common man to attach immediately by means of any such, any basic techniques, whatever they know. Okay. So there will be no information loss. There will be no, the information will be secured. That is the reason these optical fibers are used in military applications where information security is very much required. You can see, what is this one? Optical fiber communication system block diagram. So this kind of block diagrams already we have studied in the previous semesters. For example, analog communication block diagram, digital communication block diagram. This block diagram also looks similar to already the communication system block diagrams which you have studied earlier, but you can observe some differences. So what is meant by communication system? So it is a system which consists of three important parts. One is transmitter part, second one is communication channel, the third one is receiver part. Here also in optical communication these three parts are present. For example, transmitter, this is channel, and the third one is, and next one is optical receiver, okay, or receiver. If you observe, what is transmitter here? So the transmitter includes information source, electrical transmitter, and optical source. The channel includes optical fiber cable, and the receiver includes optical detector, electrical receiver, and the destination. This destination may be a loudspeaker or any unit, video unit. Okay. If you observe the transmitter part, there are two blocks. Okay. One is information source, one is electrical transmitter. These two blocks are common in any communication system that already you have studied. But if you see the third block, that is optical source, it is not present in the previous communication systems what you have studied. Okay, for example, analog communication system, digital communication system, there is no optical source. Okay, only in optical communication systems only optical sources at the transmitter end are present. Okay, if you see here, what is the optical source? Optic means light. Okay, light source. Light source means it may be LED or it may be a laser. Laser means gallium, arsenic, semiconductor, lasers generally we are using. So this kind of sources, light sources are used. It may be LED or it may be laser, okay, are used to modulate the information signal and transmit over the communication channel. So what is the communication channel here? Is it free and free space? No. Optical communication is not the communication in the free space. Okay. It needs a media, okay, it is a wide communication, okay, and it is also a specific communication channel. It is not like remaining other wide communication channels, okay, it is a fiber cable. So it is a channel, optical fiber cable, okay. So the light which is modulated along with the information signal is being transmitted into the optical fiber cable. Okay, so what this optical fiber cable will do? Will receive the information signal in the form of light from the transmitter and transmits to the receiver. So what is receiver here? You can observe three important blocks as I said earlier. So one is optical detector, electrical receiver, and destination. So electrical receiver, we already studied about different receiver circuits. Okay. Destination like loudspeaker or some video unit, that also we know it, these two are present in previous existing communication systems also. But if you see, optical detector is not present in the previous communication systems. Okay, so the main difference between the optical communication system and the existing coaxial cable system or existing communication system are, one is usage of the optical source at the transmitter end, usage of the optical detector to separate the light from the information signal, and usage of optical fiber cable. These three parts are very important, and we are going to study about these three parts in the optical communication course in this semester. Overall, whatever we are studying is about optical source, optical fiber cable, and optical detector. So these are the important blocks, and these signifies the importance as well as difference from the optical communication system from the conventional coaxial cable system. Okay. so many advantages are there of the optical communication system. One is information bandwidth is very high. You can transmit lot of information within very less time. The second one is optical fibers are small in size and the weight is very less. So these are all the advantages framed against the conventional coaxial cable system. Okay, so they are immune to noise as well as electromagnetic interference. Next one is there is no crosstalk or crosstalk is eliminated. Okay, so it is not possible to cut the optical fiber cable, okay, like conventional coaxial cable and steal the data. Okay, crosstalk is eliminated, so information security is right. Okay, you can also see so many comparison, very good comparative differences between the optical fiber and the coaxial cable. Optical fiber is used to transmit the signal in the form of light. Coaxial cable is used to transmit the signal in the form of electrical signal. Okay, optical fibers are made up of plastics and glasses. Coaxial cable is made up of copper or metal wire. In terms of bandwidth, optical fiber is very much efficient compared to coaxial cable. Next, the cost of optical fiber is high compared to coaxial cable communication system. Okay, you can also see so many differences. Okay, so very good differences are there, so which are highlighting the more number of advantages of optical fibers over the conventional coaxial cable system. Of course, there are so many advantages of optical fiber. There are some little bit disadvantages in optical fiber. You can see a complex circuitry is required at the transmitter as well as receiver. Okay, what is the reason? Because you are going to modulate an information signal with the help of light. So a specific circuit, a complex circuit is required at the transmitter as well as at the receiver. What is happening? Information signal is being separated from the light. Okay, so there also the optical detector complex circuitry is required. Okay, the next one is coupling of optical fibers is difficult. Of course, it may be an advantage because crosstalk is eliminated. Okay, but it is not possible for any man to attach the two ends of the optical fiber like a normal coaxial cable, copper cable wire. Okay, techniques like splicing techniques. There are certain techniques like splicing techniques to attach two optical fiber cable ends. Okay, the next one is maintenance is difficult. It is not possible for a normal man to maintain this entire setup, optical communication system setup. Okay, specific trained people or trained engineers, optical fiber engineers are required. The next one is separate power supplies are required at each and every repeater stage. Okay, separate 5 volts power supply is required at each and every repeater stage. Okay, these are some disadvantages of optical communication, but the advantages provided by the optical communication system, these advantages are negotiable. You can see this, there is another block diagram that is called as digital optical fiber link. Okay, you can observe all the optical communication system here are replaced by the digital circuits. For example, digital information source we are giving, encoder we are using, laser drive circuit you are using, amplifier, equalizer, decoders are you are using, and you are taking the output in the form of digital. Okay, so this is called as optical fiber digital link. Optical fiber digital link. This is also used nowadays. Coming to, if you see the block diagram, as I said, there are three important parts in the optical fiber communication system block diagram. One is optical source, one is optical fiber cable, another one is optical detector, which is at the receiver. Okay, so out of these three, first we will discuss about optical fiber cable. Okay, so optical fiber waveguides. Okay, so it is nothing but an optical fiber cable. It consists of three regions. It consists of three important regions. one is core, second one is cladding, and the third one is coating, or it is also called as sheath. Okay, so it is an optical fiber cable. The internal region, innermost region, is called as core. It is surrounded by another region called as cladding, and the cladding is surrounded by a protecting layer called as sheath or buffer. Okay, you can observe. So core, cladding, and sheath. The refractive index, we'll study what is meant by refractive index in the coming topics. The refractive cladding is always lower than the core. That is the reason the cladding always keeps the light within the core only. Always light travels within the core only. It will not go outside the core. So there is an important principle behind this actually. It is called as total internal reflection. All the optical fiber cables works on this principle only. What is the principle? Total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. Okay. So based upon this total internal reflection that is happening inside the core, okay, the optical fiber is able to carry the information in the form of light from one end to another end without any loss. In order to study about the principle that is total internal reflection, we need to learn about some basic concepts which you have already studied about in the 8th standard or 9th standard. Okay, they are loss of reflection, loss of refraction, okay, Snell's law, etc. So we have already studied them in 8th standard or 9th standard. Okay, the first one is law of reflection. What is happening here? You take a mirror. Okay, you project the light onto the surface of the mirror. This light ray is called as, it is called as incident ray. This light ray is called as incident ray. Okay, what happens when you put the light on the surface of the mirror? What happens? Light gets reflected back to the same region. Lights get reflected back to the same region. You can see here, light is getting reflected back to the same region, and this light ray is called as reflected ray. This light ray is called as reflected ray. Okay, so you can observe here, there is a dotted line here, okay, which is the normal to the mirror. Okay, so I have mentioned two angles here, say I and say r. What are those? I is the angle of incidence made by the incident ray with the normal. Another one is R. R is the angle of reflection made by the reflected ray with the normal. According to the law of reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. That is, angle of incidence I is equal to the angle of reflection, say R. This is called as law of reflection. You can see here, so incident ray is falling on the mirror. This is the mirror. Incident ray is falling on the mirror. It is getting back into the same region by making certain angles with the normal. Okay. Next one is refraction. What is meant by refraction? Refraction means bent. The word refraction means bent. So you can observe, when a light ray is passed from one medium to another medium, or one region to another region, or we can say one medium to another medium, it will not get reflected. We call it as a bend, or a specific term is there, it is called as refraction. So when a light ray passed from one medium to another medium, it changes its direction at the interface. Okay, means it bends. Okay, so here you can see when the light wave travels from less dense to more dense medium. So medium, all the mediums are not having same densities. Okay, if the light ray is passing from less dense medium to more dense medium, okay, so what is happening here? The light is getting refracted, or it is bending towards the normal. Okay, see the second case. Similarly, the light wave, when it travels from more dense medium, okay, to less dense medium, what happens? The light bends or gets refracted away from the normal. Okay, so in the first case, when the light ray is traveling from less dense medium to more dense medium, okay, what is happening here? It is bending to, means the angle of refraction is less. Okay, when it is traveling from more dense medium to less dense medium, it is going away from the normal. That is, angle of refraction is more. Okay, you can see the diagram. There are two pics here. Okay, there are two images. Okay, say this is the first image, say A. This is the second image, say B. Okay, so what is happening here? So two mediums you have taken. One is air, another one is water. Okay, so what you are doing here? You are taking a torchlight. It is a light source. Okay, you are projecting the light onto the interface. This is the interface of two media. Okay, some part of the light is getting reflected into the same medium. And some part of the light is getting refracted. It is traveling into the another medium, say water here. Another medium is water. It is able to travel into the water. Okay, and there is a bend here. See here. If you observe the refractive index, okay, say the refractive index. Is always represented using small n. Okay, say here refractive index of air is small n1, refractive index of water is n2, So what, the density of water is more than the density of air. So the refractive index of water is more than the refractive index of air. What is happening here? You can observe. Light is traveling from less dense medium to more dense medium. According to the definition, what I have said in the earlier, what is happening here? The refracted ray is coming closer to the normal, or the refraction angle of refraction is less. See the second image. Here, same two media, that is air and water. Okay, but what you have done? You have projected the light from the denser medium, say water, into the rarer medium, say air. Okay, what is happening here? So some part of the light is getting reflected back to the same medium, and some part of the light is traveling medium, okay, with a small bend. This is called as refracted ray, we already know. But if you observe, light is traveling from denser medium to rarer medium, which is making more angle of refraction with the normal. Angle of refraction is more. Okay, these two are called as The first one is angle of reflection. This is called as law of reflection. And second one is law of refraction. So as I said, what is refractive index? Okay. So refractive index, there is a definition. It is the amount of refraction or bending when that occurs at the interface of two materials or two media. Okay, in terms of numerical form also you can write the refractive index. So say small n is equal to speed of light in vacuum into speed of light in the medium. Okay, so in the next class we'll discuss about few important topics which are useful to know what is total internal reflection. This total internal reflection is the main principle behind optical communication. Thank you very much.